Welcome to the broadcast today. My name is Bill Young, and you are watching Faith is a Lifestyle. Hey, in today's broadcast, we're going into a little series that I started last week that I call Golden Nuggets. These are little bits of fabulous truth that you find in the Scripture, wonderful stories, and we're just going to concentrate on those little nuggets, and hopefully it'll bless you. Obviously, we're still under the coronavirus restrictions. As you see this broadcast, we will be on stay at home, if you will, through the month of April. But as soon as this thing breaks and turns, we'll be back to you to give you information about when we'll be gathering together for fellowship. That's what we miss most of all, and a wonderful, wonderful time in the Lord. But golden nugget number two. You know, I am becoming a little more savvy with social media. I've had a Facebook page. We've got a wonderful website, mgcconline.org. You can find some wonderful information on that site. I think we've got over 450 audio, video, and articles on that website. So if you're having an issue with a certain subject, you can go into the database and search by subject or by speaker and find the information that will bless you. But today we want to talk about following Jesus. So let's explore this a little further, this thought about following Jesus. Because in many instances, there's a great disconnect right in this area. Now, we'll turn to Proverbs chapter 3. Proverbs chapter 3, and for many believers, this is a very familiar passage of Scripture. And so we're going to break it down a little bit. You know, when Jesus called his disciples, and you find this a lot in the Gospel of Matthew, there's one phrase that you see repeated often, follow me. In fact, Jesus said in Matthew chapter 10, verse 38, any man who does not take up his cross and follow me is not worthy of me. And so there's a lot to this concept of following him. You know, Jesus told Peter one time, he caught a big catch of fish, and he said, follow me, and I'll make you fishers of men. Now, what does it mean to follow him? It's more than just studying him. But let's look at an Old Testament scripture that gives us a lot of insight on this verse. Proverbs chapter 3. And you'll find this in verse 5 and 6. It says this, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him and he will direct your paths. Now, very familiar passage to most of us, but one thing I like to do is break the scripture down so you can understand it. Now, obviously, if you've watched me for any length of time or followed this ministry for any length of time, you know that my main focus is teaching, not preaching. And, you know, I'm not like a lot of other people. This is what God has equipped me to do, and I try to run in my own lane. And so I'm not one to hoop and holler and you'll use a lot of histrionics and things like that. But if you want to learn how to apply the Word of God to your daily life, you're watching the right guy. Now, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. Now, that simply means that we should have ultimate confidence, faith in God, and we should not rely upon our understanding. Now, what does that mean? That simply means don't trust the information that comes through the five senses. Your trust should be in God, not in what you see, not in what you hear, not in what you taste or touch the senses. In fact, the Bible says in the New Testament, for we walk by faith, not by sight. What does that mean? The same thing. Trust in the Lord and not rely on the information that comes through the senses. Now, in other words, you want to run everything through the filter of God's Word. What does God's Word have to say about this? And then base your belief and your actions and your words on that truth, What does God's Word say? And so how do we get to that point where we can have that ultimate trust in Him? Well, this scripture is a roadmap to faith. It says this, in all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your paths. Now, let me go to the end of that verse, and the word paths is a Hebrew word, derech, and it literally means the course of your life. And so if you will trust in God rather than your senses and acknowledge Him, that's what we're going to talk about here in a minute, acknowledge Him in all your ways, He'll direct the course of your life. In other words, He will lead you and guide you throughout life. But what does it mean to acknowledge Him in all your ways? This is where there's a great disconnect. You know, having grown up in church and been a part of church all of my formative years, you know, we attended Baptist churches, Lutheran churches, Nazarene churches, Catholic churches. You might say, wow, boy, you guys were real church hoppers. Well, that's not the case. My father was in the military, and so we lived all over the world, and we had to move, and I think my mother counted from the time that she and my dad were married that they had moved, we had moved as a family 14 times, and so that's why we attended all these various churches. We're not church hoppers, but it just so happens we had to move from place to place. So here's where the disconnect comes in. Acknowledge Him in all your ways. When I became a member of the Pentecostal Holiness Church, acknowledging the Lord was a big thing, especially if you had a testimony service. I want to give honor to God who's the head of my life, you know, and, you know, pastor, bishop, every minister in the house, and, you know, the first lady and all that stuff. And you found that people took so much time in honoring each other that it really got off track. And so what I want to do is show you what it means to acknowledge Him in all your ways. Now, the word acknowledge in the Hebrew literally means to become acquainted with Him. So become acquainted with Him in all your ways, and He'll direct the course of your life. And there again, that's the Old Testament parallel to, for we walk by faith, not by sight. So, how do you become a follower of Jesus? Well, you've got to get to know Him. And the best way to get to know Him is through the Word. And, you know, the New Testament even comes in versions that have red letters in the Gospels. You can see exactly what Jesus said about many issues in life, about many situations. And so, you know, I'm always kind of puzzled of these people who say, well, you can never comprehend God, you can never understand God. Listen, He's given us a book, 66 books therein, written by 44 different authors, and they all basically say the same thing. They're pointing to redemption, the Messiah in His redemptive work. Now, I would encourage you to begin your study in the New Testament, the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and then read the epistles, letters written to the church, and then even the book of Revelation, because the book of Revelation is not just a revelation of the end times, it's a revelation of Jesus Christ. That's what the first verse says, a revelation of Jesus Christ. That's the title of it. And so we have to get to know Him through the Word. And when you study the Word, you find what Jesus thinks about different things. You see what Jesus said about marriage, what He said about divorce, what He said about money, what He said about relationships, what He said about sin, what He said about forgiveness, what He said about mercy, what He said about faith, what He said about healing, what He said about judgment, what He said about calamity, what He said about being a neighbor, what He said about prayer. All of these things are found in the Scripture. And if you're going to follow Him, you need to become acquainted with Him. So you get to know Him through the Word. Secondly, you get to know Him by the Holy Spirit. There are two verses that correlate with each other. They're Old Testament scriptures, and then we'll share a third. But in the Old Testament, the Psalms, Psalm 119, 105 says, "Thy word, O Lord, is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." The word lamp is the Hebrew word near. And it simply means to illuminate, to turn on the light. And so God shows us how to step, how to live, where to walk through His word. And then Proverbs 20:27 says, "The spirit of man is the lamp," there again, that Hebrew word near, "of the Lord, searching all the inward parts of the belly." In other words, the spirit of man is where God turns the light on, where He illuminates us. And so there again, we can become acquainted with Him by the Spirit of God who lives within. Now, one of my favorite passages of Scripture is the 23rd Psalm. "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." Now, Jesus reveals Himself as the shepherd of the sheep. In fact, Peter called Him the great shepherd of the sheep. And so Jesus is still the shepherd of the sheep today. And so if we want to have Jesus as our shepherd, we must learn to follow Him. That's the job of a shepherd, to lead his sheep. And Jesus said also, "My sheep know my voice, and the voice of a stranger they will not follow." But who do we follow? The voice of the shepherd. We hear the voice of the shepherd through the Word of God. We hear the voice of the shepherd by the Spirit of God within us. And so make it a point to spend time in God's Word every day. You should have a good, disciplined Bible reading plan where you read Scripture every day. That's how you get to know Him, through the Word. You will never get to know God by listening to men who don't know Him. As best they can, they're going to miss it. And it always amazes me, you know, Easter season, especially Christmas season, CNN or some network will have a thing, the story of Jesus, what really happened, and you get a bunch of people who weren't there to talk about what they think about Jesus. Well, we have a record of men who were there, who lived with Him, saw Him die, and witnessed His resurrection, and then proceeded to share the good news. That's what gospel means. Good news that Jesus rose from the dead and brought righteousness back to the human family. And so these men not only lived with Him, saw Him die, and talked to Him after the resurrection, but they went on to preach the good news and laid their lives down for what they believed. And so we have the witness of these men, we have the witness of the Holy Spirit, and of course Jesus is still alive today. And He's still doing what He's always done. So take that to heart. Jesus never implored us to study Him. He wanted us to follow Him. Hey, until next week, keep putting your faith in God's Word.
Will you clap your hands right here? Come on.
You reign above every name.
Yeah. Sing, my God reigns.
My God reigns.
Sing, our God reigns, y'all.
Our God reigns.
Sing, Lord, You reign
above.